dissect the action potential into ion flow events. Action potentials are generated when sodium ions flow into cells. So earlier I said that potassium ions are at higher concentration inside a cell than outside. It turns out the sodium concentration is low inside the cell relative to outside the cell. So its sodium concentration will always be somewhat higher outside the cell. So here are our axes, the x-axis being time and the y-axis being membrane potential in millivolts. We have a voltage-gated channel, which is in its closed state to start with. So ions cannot flow through this voltage-gated channel. If the time of stimulation is at the point of the arrow shown here, after stimulation, the voltage-gated channel opens and sodium rushes into the cell. The rushing in of sodium, those positively charged ions, reduces the negative charge inside the cell and, in fact, creates a localized positive charge inside the cell, a hyperpolarization. And when that hyperpolarization reaches its peak, somewhere around 35 or 40 millivolt positive, the voltage-gated channel is inactivated. It's being capped, if you will. It's being shut off, so no further sodium can rush into this cell. That then allows the cell to return to the resting potential, which we see here. Now, the return to the resting potential occurs over time, of course, and is assisted by a voltage-gated channel that has now opened to allow potassium flow, i.e. potassium leaves the cell. So what's happened here? Let's go back. We have a voltage-gated channel that is in its closed state until stimulation, and when stimulated, the channel opens and sodium rushes into the cell. When sodium has rushed in sufficiently, the channel is inactivated, there's no further ion flow, and a voltage-gated channel opens. This channel lets potassium leave the cell so that some positive charges that rushed in the form of sodium ions can at least be reduced by the exit of potassium ions. I'll point out that the voltage-gated potassium channel was activated by the membrane depolarization that occurred in the first place. So we have a voltage-gated potassium channel opening up and allowing potassium to leave the cell. This results in a return to the resting potential, at which point the sodium channel is now no longer inactive, but it is closed. So what we've seen here in looking at the sodium channel is that it can exist in three conformational states: closed before stimulation, open upon stimulation, and inactivated upon the maximal stimulation. And then eventually, in order that the cell can respond again and generate a second action potential, the resting potential has to be reestablished and this sodium channel has to be closed but not inactive. It has to be in its original conformation.